Alright, continuation. Walking in the spiritual. And we've been in this production, it's taking us 2 Sundays, and then next I just realized that next Sunday the thing don't finish. This series is something you must go and listen to over and over again. Walking in the supernatural, amen. We're not asking you supernatural breakthrough. You already did supernatural breakthrough. Didn't you hear what I said?
Yes, sir.
The offering of Jesus Christ on the cross of Calvary made you a breakthrough. You broke through limitation as the redeemed. Not as a redeemer, as a church. Not as a church goer in a temple, not for me. But let's look at some of the keys that will help us to walk supernaturally in a natural barrier. There are certain things when it's happened, you realize it's not meant to work. For instance, when the axe head began to float, it wasn't natural. Am I correct?
Yes, sir.
So the people went back and said, oh, like, God. But because a man who works in the supernatural was around. So he knew what to do for the axe head to float. It was not made for ordinary. What happened? Brother, come. Give your wife your baby. Give your wife your baby. They won't wear the white. It's actually pointing at another person. You see what I'm telling you? When they point at someone, they will be thinking, it can't be me. Why would it be me? He was helping another person say, it's you. Your wife didn't come to church today? Come and report yourself. Where is your wife? At home? Come. Yeah, give her a call. Yeah, come on, punish. Let me come on, punish. Where are you? Should I talk? There's something God wants to do for you. Go hold your wife and kiss her and love her. It will happen. Now let me tell you, I'm not joking. The reason why the enemy is fighting at this point is because there's something that's about to happen to your family, a breakthrough for you, and you are not sensible to know it. You should be humble and cool. You have suffered enough. At this point, you will miss it. Do you hear what I said? I talked to you as a father. You know what he told me? If I start washing, I said, if I start it, I won't continue. I love you. It's not that I don't like or wrong. There's something God wants to give you. Because I hear the Lord say, I will cause him to buy lands, even when he will pay.
Meet me at the altar with my father.
And what we lose is that I will cause him to buy even lands. Because the enemy is fighting, and he's not sensitive to know that this is not ordinary. And before you know it, anger and things. Come on, let's pray for this example. It's an attack against him. So I have to pray.
Meet me at the altar with my father. Meet me at the altar with my father. Meet me at the altar.
I want you to pray for him like you're praying for yourself. Pray for him. It's a season he wants to enter that he will look back and say, finally God has remembered me, and the enemy is still tricking. The signs are there, things are changing all of a sudden. Come on, pray for him, please. Please, this is not a matter to discuss. It's a matter to pray. Pray for him. Pray for him. Pray for him.
Jesus with me. Yes.
Amen.
Yeah.
Firstly, you have then the first key that will help you to walk supernaturally in the natural realm is your commitment to biblical principles. What's going on? Are you there? There's someone this way, I heard a lot said, your mom has become an issue to you. There's an issue pertaining to your mom. Stand up. Stand up. Stand up. Stand up. If you're the one, stand up. And run to the altar. Quickly. Quickly. I give you 2 minutes. Run 2 minutes. It's your mom. Come. I saw a lady also involved in this. Don't know whether the enemy is making you to forget that there is an issue pertaining to your mom. Run, I give you 2 minutes again. Transfer forth your hands for them. Now, let there be a divine intervention now. Stand forth, angels. Lord, look at them one by one. Visit their homes. Visit their mothers. Visit their mothers. Visit their mothers. In the name of Jesus Christ, take away infirmity. Take away confusion. Save life. Deliver lives. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Amen. Give God glory as we return back to your seat because it's done. If you believe it, come on, somebody clap your hands for Jesus if you really want to die.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Your commitment to biblical principles is one of the keys. So we're going to look at spiritual growth and development. Spiritual growth and development. There are certain things you cannot handle when you don't grow. Paul was right and he said, when you want to eat meat, eat bones, you are still struggling with milk. He said, as a babe, you are unstable. Unstable. What does babies do? They cry over this, they cry over that, they cry over this. Even if you give them, they don't want to give you back.
Yes, sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir.
God doesn't allow such ones to walk in the supernatural. Because when God wants to use you, He wants to be sure that what He gives you, you can really give Him back. But most of us, when God tries you a little thing and asks you to give Him, you take your hand because we're a babe. We're a little child. Amen? Let's look at Abraham. In his natural realm, and God wants to translate him to supernatural realm. God wants to make a prototype of Jesus through his son. And then he said to him, give me that same son who I have given you that you longed for too long. And it almost looked impossible. You know how many of us carry only child? Only child. Amen. You protect the child and protect the child out of God. He did the same thing. Hannah. Hannah was barren. You know what it means to be barren? And finally you have one. And God said, give me the one you have. God then said, give me the type of sacrifice you were coming with all before now. Before now, Hannah comes to Shiloh with what?
Sacrifice.
Are you there? You're not talking.
Yes,
don't hit your head. Talk. He comes with what?
Sacrifice.
But when God answered him, God placed a demand before the baby comes. He said, what I want is not the type of sacrifice you are used to. I want what you needed most. When God asks you to give him what you needed most, ability to answer is a sign of spiritual and supernatural growth and spiritual maturity. Hannah was in need, but not when God is in need. You didn't hear what I said? Come on, if you help me with your men. Hannah was in need, but not when God was in need. Hannah just didn't have need to meet God's need. Seek it first. Are you here now?
Yes, sir.
Spiritual growth. Hannah would have said, what? All these years, if I give you this one, what would Belinda say to me? You didn't hear what I just said. Do you know when men will make you not to do the right thing? Remember, the mocker was waiting. She's blessed in numbers of children. And God never asked her to give the one she had. And then you would have said, why would God, after all this work I have for, and they didn't give them, it's me that had only one. God, why are you like this? It's because the demand is different. Who is blessing Belinda?
God.
You're not talking now.
God.
You see, God bless both of them. The two of them are not the same. Hey, some of your blessing business is not sinking. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
He said, give me the same thing I gave you. It's not best to see how matured. How many times have you failed maturity tests in the presence of God? He said, give me that sin. You don't think God needed your tax to build church?
No.
I can tell you no. But it is to prove your maturity, your honesty and dependability. God all of a sudden said, I depend on you to bring food in my house. Think about it. Would God actually depend on a man to feed his house? If the house of God is actually the house of God, should God depend on men water to sustain his house? No! I'm proving it over and over again. He can use anybody anywhere. But because he wants to have a covenant with you. He said, let me see, though he's on earth, I see grown mature enough to give me back what I'm about to give. Because God knows that when you are ready to obey, he will give you pressed down, shaking together, running over. He will give you what eyes have not seen. But what he's asking you is what you have seen. And then you take your hand at the back. He said to Abraham, your son, your only son, Isaac, whom thou love, give it to him. No complicity, direct. He wouldn't say, Lord, I didn't understand. He called the name, he's telling the emotional attachment. He said, this is the one I want. How many times when you want to do things for God, you do the one that's confident than the one God wants? What was the difference between Cain and Abel? It was said that God had a natural hatred for one. No, it is their ability to give God what is due to him in their supernatural code that separates one from another. Abel gave according as God expected. The Cain gave according as what he wants. And God said to Abraham, give me your son now. And it's because of the maturity of Abraham, he knew that Sarah is not mature enough to stay dead. He said to Sarah, Sarah, I, would you bless Sarah? Huh?
Remember, for many times this man come and promise. Say that with their self. But they won't. They don't come again. When they eat finish, they will prophesy. Hello. Remember, as any of the angels come, Abraham will tell Sarah, go and get the best of the cows. Am I correct?
Yes,
and prepare for this visitor. And they don't come as God, they come as priest. They don't come as God, but they come as priest. And then Abraham will say, bring the best in their house and prepare for them. They will eat a rational meat. Abraham, I just came down from heaven. There was a meeting and your name was mentioned. Abraham said, I came. He said, you will have baby. He says, God told me that my children will be like the stars of heaven. And the sisters that have lost their children. Well, is somebody here feeding him now?
Yes.
He told me that my children will be like the sand in the seashore. I can see the seashore, but I can't see the children. And now, after all said and done, the child have grown 12 years. He knows how to blend. He can go to this different errand. He can wash plates. You know, there's no time to lose a child, but there's a time that's more painful. You didn't hear what I said? Have you heard people say, if this child has died in childbirth, it would have been better than now. Come on now.
Yes, sir.
God waited until there's born. He said, give me. So Abraham says, I and the child, we are going on a 3 days journey. 3 days is enough for you to change your mind.
Yes, sir.
How many of you have ever made promise during the score? When you leave, you say, what happened to me? Now, wisdom is embraced by, not vice. You share it, and Lord say, come on. That's not it. Because when you left here, the enemy reminded you all your bills that are yet to be paid. Then you no longer walk by the Spirit, your flesh took over you. And then you begin to walk according to flesh and say, let me do what I can. And the Lord understands. All right, God understands, but you're not spiritually matured to handle spiritual issues. So he said to the wife, I am the Lord. We'll be going on a 3 days journey to Mount Horeb to go meet with the Lord. We are going to worship. Abraham didn't say, I am going to make sacrifice. He said, we are going to worship unto the Lord. And he said to the son, you and I are going to sacrifice unto the Lord. The son is already aware of the natural way of sacrificing. But there's a way the father knew that he didn't know. It is another way of sacrificing, which was him. Your spiritual growth. Make you to stick to God, even when all of a sudden what you thought it would bring, but it didn't bring it. Stick to God, even when it looks as if that I thought, Lord, when I paid my sacrifice, I would have gotten this, and now I didn't get this. Why should I pay again? It is not your first attempt that made it. It is your consistency in it. He said, they continue. And now when they are getting to the bottom of the mountain, the son spoke. In the person like you go cry. He said, okay, Lord, see now, even the child now is crying. You have to cry too, don't you leave? Because it is not touching at that point. But you see, when the sign of maturity is your ability to separate emotion from worship. Did you hear what I said? Huh?
Yes, sir.
Do you know I can see children crying, I'll start crying?
Yes.
Does it mean that what is spending her is spending me? It is just emotional. I just felt for her. Probably as I love to be married. Yeah, she also as I love you. I don't talk about you, I love you. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hey. Now. It is a much more bothersome upon the mountain. They didn't go to the valley. They climbed, making sacrifice to make sacrifice.
Hey!
Did you hear what I just said to you?
Yes,
making sacrifice to do what?
Yes,
to climb mountain is not a day journey. They began to climb and go to the top. And then he laid the altar. The sacrifice upon the altar. And he turned and said, the willing son. Did you hear what I said? The willing son. Did you hear what I just said? It's not the son that will ask much question. He only asked question. The father said that God will provide the object of sacrifice. But when he now became the object of sacrifice, he offered himself, just like Jesus was not rebellious unto the father to make you a redeemer. Are you hearing what I'm saying? To redeem you and I, he offered. So Isaac offered himself as a prototype of what is to come. And the father went, ready to kill. How many of you know sometimes when you give some kind of money to the altar, blood comes out of you? Come on now, some of you have not tested it. Real blood, you bleed, you cry, you give it to you. It's actually God, who's all the God of the world. While I was in the church, I came for the wedding. I saw your sacrifice of the, what do you mean? You made the sacrifice of television and microwave. It's still there in the office. And then I said, the one who made this sacrifice, what happened? I said, it's a sweet word. And now as I'm preaching, it reminded me again. Probably after I preach today, I can now take it to my house. I'll be able to use an office. Ask God anything, two of you who your names and ask God anything. I'll come to you. Have you finished? That was what they got to start life. And they gave it. Many years ago. I think it's over 3-4 years now. Remember? Close to 3 years or 4 years. And I, after I finished reading, I just went up. I just said, wow. He said to me, the Lord said, don't touch! We passed the exam. The passage of Abraham, I provided for myself an object of sacrifice. So it means when God was asking, it was just a test. Before God asked, he has provided. So for adventure, it was not because God was hungry. He has enough. Yet he asked, man. And the Bible says, the man held in the ticket on the horn. Violent animal became humble because the man was obedient. He didn't travel, he prevailed. As he touched the animal, it yielded for sacrifice because he himself has sacrificed. So the animal was not unto God's sacrifice. Listen to me. It was a covenant initiated between God and Abraham for his obedience. He said, now I know. How come God don't know what the why? You didn't hear what I said? He said, now I know. The angel that was speaking said, don't touch. Now I know that thou feareth God. So you see, Abraham, all this while, the angel didn't trust Abraham until he comes to the things that pertains to his blood. I fear God. And when he touched you for blood, he said, now I know if you can give this one, there's nothing you can give back to me. And God said, I will make you. He didn't say you will become. I will make you. I will work it out. You will be the father of all nations. Listen to me. You will be blessed. Anyone who bless you will be blessed. Anyone you curse will be cursed. Anyone who curse you will be cursed. Anyone who wants blessing will just go and say, take. So if men want blessing, they will die from them. You see, that's why don't get jealous of somebody who is blessed. Go and congratulate the person who is blessed. It can just be the link to your own blessing. Stand on your feet, everybody. Next week, I promise I will not sing long. Look at our congratulations. Have you asked God? All right. Open your hand. May your sacrifice speak for you. May you return back to this house not many days from today and come back to see this God of this commission who has seen you, who has seen your tears, whom you have trusted. May Him alone, may Him alone turn things around for you in Jesus' mighty name. Use your oil as you wish. Go, congratulations. Everybody, lift your hands to God. Lift your hands to God. Joy, I thought you had the microphone. Lift your hands to God.
Amen. No name, no.